Well, we are live at the Puritan Conference Center, and both Governor Lynch and his opponent, John Stephen, agree this is going to be a tight race. The latest poll showing that Lynch's lead has slipped to 8 points. But Governor Lynch is very optimistic. He cast his vote today at his hometown of Hopkinton with his wife, Dr. Susan Lynch, and his daughter, Julia. Lynch also shared a few words with former Supreme Court Justice David Souter. Lynch said today voters appreciate his steady leadership.
I feel very good. The response has been very positive. I think people recognize how much better New Hampshire is doing than so many other states around the country. They know our unemployment is low compared to other states.
Now, if Lynch wins this fourth term, he will be the first governor to serve that fourth term in recent modern history. And he will also be the only Democrat, or one of the only Democrats, to overcome this Republican wave. Now, for more on his opponent, John Stephen, we'd like to hand it over to Heather Hamill.
Well, John Stephen's campaign has been very busy for the past hour or so here at the executive court, setting up the room for the party that's expected to begin in about 2 hours. Now, this has become a closer race than originally thought. And for Stephen, he believes it's because people are just looking for change. Now, at Hillside Middle School, where he voted this morning with his wife, Jenny, John Stephen shook hands and tried to talk to as many voters as possible. Stephen is a former assistant attorney general, as well as the Health and Human Services Commissioner. He isn't taking much stock in polls, only the issues.
Oh, I'm feeling great. You know, the voters of our state will decide today, and it's been a great campaign, and I'm so optimistic about the future, and I feel strongly about making sure we keep New Hampshire values of limited government, less spending alive and well for our future generations.
Now, the Stephen campaign expects for this to be a very close race and a very long night, and as for the supporters, they're expected to start arriving around 8 o'clock tonight. Reporting live in Manchester, Heather Hamill, WMUR News 9.